Today on Beyond Boundaries, Iranian human rights lawyer Nasreen Sidote is awarded the Sakharov Prize for Freedom of Thought. And a suicide bomber kills 41 people in northern Afghanistan after Eid prayers. An unusual mix of a hurricane and winter storm is likely to hit most of the East Coast this coming week. Beyond Boundaries starts right now. Welcome, I'm Shaan Shaikh. In September 2010, the Iranian government imprisoned Nasreen Sidote for defending protesters after the 2009 presidential election. Sidote has already served two of her six-year sentence for human rights activities, acting against the national security and propaganda against the regime. She has spent over 100 days in solitary confinement and remains in Iran's notorious Evin prison. Sidote received the Sakharov Prize while on a hunger strike to protest the authorities' refusal to allow visits with her 13-year-old daughter and 5-year-old son. Sidote has continued this strike for 13 days. Jafar Panahi, another Iranian dissident, was also awarded the prize. A suicide attacker killed dozens outside of a mosque in northern Afghanistan after Eid prayers. Witnesses say the attacker looked to be around 14 or 15 years old and was dressed in police uniform. He was able to get past all security checkpoints, standing outside of the mosque, waiting for the prayer to end. Although the terrorist is believed to have been targeting members of the Afghan military and security forces, 17 civilians were killed and 5 were children. The Afghan president, Hamid Karzai, made a speech urging members of the Taliban and other government opposition groups to stop destroying the country and killing its people. He calls the perpetrators the enemies of Islam and humanity. No group has yet claimed responsibility for the attack. Forecasters have warned that Hurricane Sandy, combined with a winter storm from the west, will hit the East Coast this week. To make things worse, the storm is likely to hit during a full moon when the tides are near their highest. With this increase in coastal flooding potential, the White House is warning citizens to listen to local officials and monitor weather reports. Before the storm, make sure your gutters are free of debris, your cell phone is fully charged, and you're well stocked up on non-perishable items. You can find additional tips online at most weather stations. Thanks for joining us on Beyond Boundaries, where we bring you the news beyond all borders. We remind you to go out and vote on November 6th, and please stay safe during the storm. See you next week.